All right, so this is another DPI Presents, and happy holidays to each one of you. My name is Roslyn Rice. I am co-founder of DPI, and I am so excited that each of you are taking the opportunity to really think about your goals for 2022. I'm going to share my screen because I have a few slides that I want you to see, but when it comes to each of you reaching your goals, let's think about what is a goal. And I know that this seems sometimes so elementary on what a goal is, but in its simplistic definition, a goal is you setting out to achieve something. It is setting a mark and then you moving towards achieving and obtaining whatever that mark you have set for yourself. So an example of some goals is, I want to increase my sales 20% this quarter. I want to lose 5 pounds by the end of the month. I want to become a better leader. I want to launch a referral program for my existing clients. We all have those different mile markers of places where we want to go. And so this is going to help jumpstart us into thinking about 2022. So there are two different types of goals. There are short-term goals, and that is really looking at daily, monthly, quarterly, what you want to achieve. And many times you'll take a larger goal and move it into a short-term goal. Then we also have long-term goals. Long-term goals is just expanding the length of time that you want to look out. So whether it's 3 years or 5 years or 10 years, you will look out. And really, when you're looking out that amount of time, that's more what I consider strategic planning. And this is one of the places where DPI, this is one of our most requested packages, is where we have strategic planning, where you're looking out 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, and then you work your way back. We call it reverse goal setting to be able to get to your short-term goals. You always want to make sure that your short-term goals align with your long-term goals or your strategic pillars that you have for your organization. So it's important that if you haven't looked further out than a year, that you spend some time really thinking about, where do you want to be at the end of 3 years, 5 years, 10 years? So why are goals important? Again, I know this is going to seem elementary, but we'll get into the meat of this pretty soon, but I wanted to set this foundation. Goals are important because they provide focus. They create a focus for you when you are, you know, trying to figure out what is the road ahead. They provide clarity on what you want to achieve. Because I always say, if you do not define your measure of success, then someone else will define it for you. Goals also provide direction. They help you set the direction of your organization. And you, as a business owner, it is important for you to know what direction your company is going to go into. It helps navigate the path forward. It helps you outline the priorities. What are your priorities? All of us have limited resources. There are so many things that we're presented with that we want to do, but that doesn't mean we have the resources to do them. So goals help you set the priorities of where you want to steward your limited resources. The other thing, goals are motivators. When you are able to achieve a small win, it motivates you to keep on going. Let's say that you've made a goal that you want to get out of debt and you pay off one of your credit cards. That mile marker or that small win will help motivate you to move on to something larger, because in your mind, you're like, I can do it. I can do it. So goals are truly motivators. Here's a quote that I love. Productivity is not just getting more done. Productivity is focusing on what matters the most. And the only way you can know what matters most is if you have set goals. Again, goals provide priorities, but also the direction of your organization. All right. So what are we going to do now? I want you to take some time, about 4 or 5 minutes, and I'll set the foundation here, to think about what has worked well in 2021. Knowing some of you that are on this call, I want you to think about from a financial perspective, from a marketing perspective, operations. I want you to think about multiple categories within your business. What has worked well from a people perspective, your systems, even your personal habits, because it's all integrated together. What has worked well? So for instance, when I say financial, 70%, you might say, I have 70% new clients in 2021. Or from a marketing perspective, you might be thinking, I've invested in social media ads. And maybe that is something new that you've never done before. That is a win for you. That is something that has hopefully worked well for you. From operations, maybe you added an online store for your company. That is something that is a win, that is a large win for you. From a people perspective, maybe you've added a virtual assistant, or you've, you know, interviewed someone that you might consider bringing on in another year. That becomes a win for you. From a systems perspective, maybe you've invested in online scheduling, or you have a tool where you schedule all of your social media posts. That is a win. From a personal habits perspective, maybe this year you've started incorporating more mindful moments, you've started meditation, or you have decided to drink more water. Whatever it might be, I want you to write down what has worked well. Now, when you're doing this, what I don't want you to do, and this is important, you might say, all right, my business has grown 25%, but I'm spending less time with my family. Do not judge yourself, okay? Don't add the but. When you write down what works well, because a lot of times it's hard for us to do that, just focus on what has worked well for you and don't add in the, but I'm da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Just focus on what has worked well, the big wins, the small wins. So I'm going to give you about 5 minutes. I'm going to play a little holiday music for us, but it's important for you to really think about what has worked well, because this becomes a springboard into our next activity. Yes.
when you talk about writing down what has worked well, is it just for this year, or are we looking at since we've been in business or?
In 2021.
In 2021, okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Anybody else have any question? All right, we got about 3 more minutes. All right, ladies. So since we are such a small group, was that hard to do, to think about different ways that you have had small wins, large wins in 2021? Reflect your reflection. Was that hard or easy? You can put it in the chat too.
I felt like it was easy. Of course, I utilize you as my consultant, so you have me reflect quite often. It's now become a part of my culture.
Yeah.
And my process and system.
Yes. Every week, I'm asking you what your wins for the week was. Anybody else? All right. If not, we'll move on to, before you set any goals, the reflection part of it is so very important, because again, it is important to look at what has worked well, what has not worked well before you go and set any goals. So I want us to look at, and this will only take us about 3 minutes, what has not worked well. And sometimes this is the easiest thing to do, because we're constantly beating ourselves up on maybe a goal that we have not obtained. So this process will probably be a little bit faster, but what has not worked well? Again, using the categories of financial, marketing, operations, people, systems, personal habits. This is not just for business, from a professional development to, you know, what is going on in your personal life. So what has not worked well? Also, when you think about what hasn't worked well, think about what resources do you still need? And many of us, that list probably will become long. I like to say, you know, many of us can have dreams, but sometimes our dreams die on the concrete of someone's opinion. So what needs to be resurrected? What is a dream that possibly needs to be resurrected? I know for me, being able to write a book this year, actually, I wrote it last year, but published it this year. that was a dream that just had died. It was something I had in my heart for 10 years. And this was the year that it actually came into being. So what, think about what might be holding you back from when you're looking at what hasn't worked well. What might be some of the obstacles? For some of us, it's just our mindset. It could be our inner critic that we need to silence that says, you can't do that. Nobody wants to read that. Why are you thinking about you're, you know, strong enough or smart enough to do that? So sometimes it's an inner critic, but identify any obstacles that you have in regards to your goals. I want you to know, in the midst of 2021, we've done many different activities, and it's so important for us to look at what has worked, what has not worked. But it's important to look at what has not worked well, because we don't want to have history repeat itself. So that is the reason why this activity is in there. So I'm gonna go back to the Christmas music, three more minutes for you to think about what has not worked well. And again, don't offer any judgment, just worked what hasn't worked well, okay? All right, so that went a little bit faster again, because I don't want us to go too far down the rabbit hole of what has not worked. But so now you should have a list of what has worked well and what has not worked well. Now where we're going to go is I want you to think about this time next year. So you're getting ready to send that Christmas letter, and you're going to put what your family has achieved, or you're getting ready to, you know, write a performance review. How do you want to show up in 2022? And this is where the worksheet that I provided you will come in handy. It is proven that it's important to set goals, but you increase your ability to effectively achieve those goals significantly when you write them down. That's why I wanted to make sure that I provided that link on this tool that we created that just simply allows you to write down what it is that you want to achieve in 2022. Again, It could be personal, it could be professional. But how do you want to show up in the world next year? How do you want to show up in regards to you, if you have children, for your family, those relationships that you have, for your friends? Some of us might have said, what didn't work well, I didn't spend a lot of time with my friends this year because I was so busy, you know, launching my business or launching this new program. So how do you want to show up for your friends next year or your clients? What do you want to achieve? And you can really think about spiritual, mental, personal, financial, career, physical, all of those different areas, because it's all linked together. And when you are writing these achievements, you're going to think about, in light of what has worked well, in light of what did not work well, what is it that I want to achieve in 2022? So I'm just going to throw out some ideas, not that you need to write any of this down, but just to kind of as a little mental warm up. There might be someone here that might say, you know what, I want to get my business ready to sell. I want to hire an assistant. I want to start a ministry, make an impact on homelessness. I want to write a book. I want to launch a coaching program. I want to utilize a monthly budget. I want to get out of debt. I want to exercise more. I want to add profit into my business. I want to engage more followers on social media. There are so many things that we might decide, this is how I want to show up. This is how I want my brand to show up. There is a client that we have that was really struggling when I said, you know, put profit into our business, was struggling to have profit into the business. DPI was able to come alongside that business, set some systems in place. And now every single month, every single deposit, really, there is profit being put into that business. So it's important for you to be able to articulate it, write it down, and visualize where you are going, because goals provide that direction and that motivation. So ask yourself, how do you want to show up in 2022? So I'm going to give you about 4 minutes for this. So around 10:27 for this part of it. So the Christmas music is coming back on, but really think about 2022. What do I want to achieve by this time next year?
I said you were the very first love you had, but it hurt your heart real bad. He just led your feelings astray, and on a holiday, go ahead and cry. Let me clear each tear from your eye, and baby, sing you a lullaby. Let my heart. It's all so hard to let go. Give yourself time to heal, take it slow. Let's talk as the rainbow. Colored lights make the tree glow. I'm your man, I will be here for you till the end. Cause I don't wanna see her again. Back.
All right. So this is, I know that time goes so fast. And obviously, this is what you see on your screen is the sheet that I was referencing, where you can talk about your accomplishments and what it is that you want to achieve. Now, I will say this, this is still not your goals. This is just where you are looking in light of your wins, in light of what didn't work well, what it is that you want to achieve in 2022, but it's still not a goal yet. So when you look at this list that you've started to write, I want you to write in that second column, why is it important? And the reason why I put that before it becomes a goal, the first process, we're just brainstorming, we're just thinking, and some of that stuff is relevant, some of it isn't relevant. So I want you to think to yourself, why is it important? And after you answer that question, then say, are you sure this is what you want to achieve? Because sometimes we can have this large goal that is so intimidating. And when we sit back and really think about it, we decide, you know what, maybe that goal should be put off for another year. There's other goals that are a higher priority. So with that list, ask yourself, why is it important? And are you sure that you want that to become one of your achievements for 2022? And notice on here, it says next year accomplishments. And I think that what Camille put into the chat, it's very important for you to visualize it first that you've already achieved this goal. Okay. So when you look at the what you have on your list, there are three different type of goals that we have. One is a project-based goal. And a project-based goal normally has a start and a finish. So for me, when it was time for me to launch my book, I knew when I was starting and I knew it was launching on March 30th. So I had a start and a finish. That is a project-based goal. The other type of goal is an activity-based goal. So an activity-based goal is normally centered around our metrics. It's normally something where we say, I want to increase my followers by 20% on social media. That's a metric-based goal. Or I want to increase my sales by 30%. That is a metric-based goal. So you have project, you have activity, and then you have habit-based. And normally this will fall around health and wellness. So you might say, I want to take 20 minutes every day to just sit still, to meditate, to set my intention for the day. That would be a habit-based goal. Or I want to drink 8 glasses of water. That's going to be a habit-based goal. I want to work out 3 to 4 times a week. So when you're looking at that list, I want you to write whether it is a project-based goal, an activity-based goal, or a habit-based goal. Okay, so I just gave you a few things to do. Let me give you another 4 minutes. So you're looking at your list, putting why is it important? Are you sure that you want to achieve that in 2022? and then decide, is it a project-based, activity-based, or habit-based goal?
Roslyn.
Yes.
What did you say was an activity-based goal? Say it's that again.
An activity-based goal is normally around metrics. So financial goals, it could be you want to increase your customer base, your client base by 30%. It's wherever there's a metric, a measurable metric that you can put to it.
Okay. So one of my goals is lose in 2022, I'm going to lose 15 pounds. So what's that?
A metric. I mean, that is an activity-based goal.
Activity. Okay.
Because you'll be able to measure that.
Okay. Okay. And a project would be like writing a book.
Yes. Something that has a start and a finish, like a hard start and finish to it.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
It's Christmas now.
Okay, I know that you might not be all the way done. That's okay. But I just wanted to take like 5 minutes, you know, 3 to 5 minutes for us to share if you feel comfortable, only if you feel comfortable. If you wanted to share any of your, it could be your wins, it could be, you know, a way you want to show up in 2022. It could be something that didn't work well. Does anyone want to share? No, obviously, Renee, you've already shared that, you know, losing weight is a way you want to show up in 2022. But anybody else would like to share? No.
For me, being that I haven't officially launched, that's one of my goal for 2022. So that, and then just to have time to meditate, to, you know, be still.
Yes.
And to be active. So those are some of mine.
Okay. That's great. Yep. You're in the trademark process. So you are.
Yeah.
Waiting. So that was a win, right? Did you put that as a win?
For the trademark?
That you're waiting, that you've started the process?
Yeah. That was a win. That was probably, that's my only win for my business so far. And then also, you know, the testimonies that I told you about with the two people.
Yes.
Yeah. So those are my wins.
Awesome. And Brandy put, I just opened my first, business, Brandy? I need to be more proactive with my new business as a new specialist. Okay. Good.
For me, something that didn't work well, Roslyn, was my time management. Like, and I know that fortunately you're going to be working with my team and I on that, but mm-hmm. time management is something that didn't work well. I think I can be a little bit more efficient. So
yes, you and Victoria are in the process of your time log and tracking. And so, yes. So it's good. It's sometimes hard to be honest with ourselves as a full specialist. Okay. Awesome, Brandy. That's exciting. That is, I'm just so proud of you ladies, even taking out the time, because many times we don't take ourselves out of the business so that we're focused on our business. We're just constantly just in the day-to-day. So very, very good. All right. So I'm going to go back to sharing my screen. And so let's think about setting SMART goals, because we've talked about what we wanted to achieve, what didn't work well, what worked well, and what we want to achieve in 2022. We still don't have our goals yet. So wins and opportunities become a springboard. And this is what I like to say: success and failure leave a rabbit trail of clues. So that's why the reflection part before you do any goal setting is so imperative, because there's a little rabbit trail of clues on what you should do next. Some of that is just looking at your historical data, looking at your sales, looking at if it's from an exercise perspective, what worked well, what didn't work well. So when it comes to, many of us have heard about SMART goals, but it's important for us in regards to SMART goals to start defining these achievements into goals. And how do we do that? Well, we want to make sure that we're analyzing historical data. Data shows us a treasure full of information that will help us decide what the next step should be. You want to synthesize your experiences. Every day you're doing something different. There's a different activity that you're doing. So you got to synthesize all that information so you can chart a path forward. If you're in retail, as I am in retail, trend projections, based on what's selling now, what do I project or predict to sell in the future? So your goals, specific. You want to make sure that we remember the five questions, right? The who, what, where, when, and why. When you write your goals, you want to write them with precision and with clarity, and you want to put as many details as possible. So in the beginning, I talked about a few goals, but I specifically made them incredibly generic. I want to lose weight. I want to sell more books. I want to sell more lawn blowing services. I want my business to grow. Those goals are so incredibly generic, and you will become frustrated in the process of trying to achieve that goal. Because what is, I want my business to grow? What does that even mean, right? They don't define a road of success. So you want to narrow down that vision and really focus specifically who, what, where, when, and why, so that there is maximum effectiveness in achieving that goal. The M, goals should be measurable. Ladies, listen, we all want evidence that we are making progress towards our goal. So there needs to be evidence to prove to you that you're on the right track. Because if you set a goal and you think that you've never achieved it, you're going to get frustrated and you're going to stop trying to achieve that goal. So I want you to think about, when I say measurable, income, dollars, pounds lost, hours saved. When, you know, Renee, you talked about focusing on time management, you're going to be able to see, oh my goodness, I was able to save 4 hours of time here. You want to truly be able to put a measurable perspective around your goal. All right. So it's one of the reasons I like to use this as an example. When you go to the doctor and you're in pain, they're going to say, on a scale from 1 to 10, what is your pain level, right? Has that ever happened to any of you? And then when you say, okay, my pain is at an 8. And then later on, they'll say, okay, what is your pain level? Oh, my pain is a 6. They know, because it's been measured, that there is progress on bringing that pain level down. So we want to make sure that we do that with our goal. All right. Again, we want, many of us are striving for this kind of perfect, flawless, but it's all about progress. And a measurable goal allows you to have that. So instead of just saying, I want to lose weight, to be measurable, you'll say, I want to lose 5 pounds by January 31st, 2022. Or instead of just saying, I want to increase my followers, you will say, I want to start, instead of saying, I will increase my Facebook followers, I want to increase my followers on my Facebook page by 20%. So that means that if you're starting at 100 followers and you add 20 more, you know that you've made that goal because you put a measure around it. I want to start, you know, meal planning on Sundays, so I set myself up for success during the week. I want to increase my sales activity by 30% by adding 10 additional calls a week. These are all measurable and more specific. All right. So the next thing is achievable. You want to be able to have a goal that is achievable, something that is attainable, something that stretches you, but you still are able to obtain it. If you put something out there, like let's say you lost 1 pound in a month and you put a goal out there that says, I'm gonna lose 50 pounds in 2 months. I mean, come on, based on your past experience, right? You know that that is not an achievable goal. So what happens when we do unrealistic goals? Unrealistic goals, as you can see on the screen, they're too lofty. They're intimidating. Your team will not be motivated by them and they are not attainable. So that is why it's important for you to constantly reflect to see what has worked well, what has not, so that you know that you are making that very achievable goal. Okay. You want to use your historical data. It provides you a lot of information. And this is where a business consultant, and I saw your comment, Camille, it's so true. I hold you accountable, right? It's important because you can set a goal, but you also need to have that accountability. The R, so moving on, the goal needs to be relevant. Are you willing and able to put time and effort to achieve this goal? If you're not willing and able, then it's not relevant to you. If you're making a short-term goal, does that short-term goal tie back to your long-term goal? Again, it needs to be relevant. Will it move you towards your 5-year goal? So if in any way you're unsure of like, Roslyn, I don't know where I want to be next week versus in 5 years. I'm going to talk at the end about a session that we have in a huge savings so that you can kind of jumpstart in making sure that you have those strategic priorities. So the last is time bound. You want to set a time frame for your goals. You want to make sure that your goal has time, that it's not just like inevitable whenever it happens. It's just kind of floating out there. You want to be able to put a time. If it's a strategic priority, that is kind of timeless. But when it comes to the actual goals that you're setting, it needs to have a time frame for it. And I will say you need someone to hold you accountable. So I'm going to give you a few examples of what actually becomes a SMART goal, because what you wrote on how you want to show up on that paper is not the goal, right? So I will lose 10 pounds. Remember, it started generic. I'm going to lose weight, but here's a SMART goal. I will lose 10 pounds within the next 3 months by going to the gym 5 times a week, for an hour and eating balanced meals every 4 hours. I will keep a food diary for 1 month to ensure success. So that is an example of how a very generic goal became a SMART goal. Another one, I just want to increase my sales. I want my business to grow. Well, that's not specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, time bound. So how do you change that? I will increase sales by 25%. By obtaining 10 more new clients by the end of the year and selling our new subscription program. That way you have that mile marker. Okay, the end of the year, I'm working towards 10 new clients and I'm going to be converting them into our new subscription program. So was that helpful to understand the difference between generic versus a SMART goal? Was that helpful, ladies?
Very helpful. Okay. Very, very, very helpful.
Okay. Okay. Yes, Camille said yes. All right. So we talked about the unrealistic goals. I just wanted to let each of you know that next year we will be launching a program. It's called Year of Consulting, and we will talk about every single month a different topic that is important for new business owners or business owners that are veteran business owners. We'll talk about goals, productivity, social media content, client management, overcoming rejection. We'll have special speakers. We'll talk about trend projections, all of that. So I just wanted to let you all know that is something that DPI will be offering. So more information will come in regards to that. So I wanted to give you just a little added bonus because we've talked about goals. So, you know, when we finish this, keep the momentum going, go back and look at how you can make your achievements for 2022, the ways you want to show up, craft those into specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, time-bound goals. Make those into SMART goals. But I wanted to give each of you ladies a little bit of my favorite time hacks. So this is just a little added bonus. Again, I used that quote earlier that says productivity is not about getting more done. And a lot of people think about, oh, today was a productive day. I got so much done. Productivity is about focusing on what matters the most. So you could be getting a lot done, but it's not getting you any closer to your goal. And that's why goals are important. So here are five time hacks that I use, and I consider myself a very productive person. Time blocking. I will make sure that I block time in my calendar for, let's say, reading emails. If you try and read an email every single time it comes into your inbox, that is a time waster because we receive about 100 plus emails a day on average when you think about your professional and your personal email. So time waster. Time blocking is an hour in the morning, an hour before I wrap my day, I am going to set that time aside for a reading and responding to my emails. You will find that you're not going to have that constant invasion within your day. And that has been a huge time saver for me. The other thing that I do is online appointment scheduling. Sometimes I could spend more time trying to set up time to meet with someone versus the actual meeting itself. So on our website, we have where you can just schedule time. Our calendar is up to date so that it's not someone texting you, hey, can you meet tomorrow at 5 p.m.? No, you can just go onto our calendar, and the online scheduling, automating that process has been such a time saver for us. The other thing I utilize, and my mom definitely knows this, is do not disturb. When I am in the midst of a mission critical project, my do not disturb is on. For instance, right now, I want to be completely engaged in this webinar. And so my do not disturb is on because the notifications that we get from LinkedIn, social media, from just you have a new order out there, whatever it might be, can be so intrusive in our day. So do not disturb is huge for me to be fully engaged in the activity that I'm doing. Another thing is I've read a lot of research on this, rethink multitasking. Multitasking actually slows down your efficiency because the brain is made to focus on one thing at a time. So if you're sitting there and you're thinking to yourself, I'm listening to this webinar, but I'm also checking my email, your brain is only able to do one thing at a time. So multitasking, my executive coach has told me about this, and there's a lot of research out there. It actually hinders your progress. So rethink multitasking. The other thing is my morning rhythm. I make sure in the morning it's a non-negotiable space. I don't care who is calling me. Renee can attest to this. She might be calling me. My mom's calling me. If I'm not through with my meditation, prayer time, and my exercise, I'm not answering the phone. So morning for me sets the tone of my day. And when it just runs away with me, like just don't go online, looking at social media, that will set your tone for the day. And it could be in a positive or a negative space. So those are just five of my own personal time hacks that I use. Did anyone, I'm going to check the chat here. So true. She will not take my call in the morning. You know how that is. I will not take your call in the morning. Did anybody else have a time hack that you use that might be helpful to any of us?
If you had left out multitasking, I was going to be like, Roslyn, you forgot one, because that is something that I am working on after you have gotten on me about not being in the moment. I've tried to multitask all the time and I've tried to be more diligent. Like, I was actually going to take this call while driving to work, and I'm like, you know what? No. I'm going to pull over. So I am sitting in an IHOP parking lot and I am taking this call because I wanted to focus and not have my mind all over the place. I needed to get better with the do not disturb, because I will, and Victoria knows this, I will go down a rabbit hole, open my phone up to send a text, see that somebody else has texted me. So yeah, this was good.
Yes, good, Renee. Yes. Definitely something I need to work on as well. Yeah, the multitasking is huge. And Renee, I know I drive you crazy by not answering the phone, but it's my sacred space. So we are actually going to finish early. How about that? Like, nothing like a goal setting class to give you back more time. But I do want to tell you that as a thank you, there is something special that we are offering. It's only valid through December 31st. I talked a lot about our strategic planning package, which Camille has gone through, Renee has gone through. This is one of our most requested packages. We are offering $200 as a savings for this. It's a 3-session bundle. You can do it in 2 to 3 sessions. So you can do 3 1-hour sessions, or you can do 2 1.5-hour sessions. It's totally up to you, and they can be done virtually. And it is a strategic planning bundle. It kind of goes much, much further into what has worked well, what hasn't worked well for your business. And then really deciding in 5 years, 3 years, where it is that you want to be, because you want those strategic pillars for your organization. And even from a career development perspective, the bundle again lasts until December 31st. You can go on our website and you can schedule. There's a little pop-up that comes that says schedule time with us. I think it says in the bottom right-hand corner, that pop-up, if you go and you do the strategic planning bundle and you use this coupon code, you will be able to get $200 off of that package. So I thank each and every one of you ladies. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. If you're in the midst of Hanukkah, happy Hanukkah. I wish all of you well, and thank you so much for attending. And even if you're watching on replay, I hope that this has been beneficial to each of you. Awesome class. Thank you, Renee. So have a great afternoon. Be well.